Chipsee Android product is rooted, but can we run Python on this 7-inch industrial Android tablet? With the help of Termux, we can. And we can not only run Python, but we can also run Ruby, Node.js, or even most Linux software. The best part is, this is an industrial tablet which gives you native RS232, RS485, GPIO with a touch panel running Android. You can move your Linux software code to this device and start a webview. You get an Android touchscreen experience with the programming languages and software you know, and this device is rooted by default. You can literally do whatever you want, thanks to Termux. In this video, I'm gonna show you how I install Termux and Python and then start a HTTP web server in this Android tablet and use pyserial to let two devices talk to each other through native RS485 serial ports in an Android web browser. So at the beginning, I connect the Android tablet and my Mac with a Type-C cable, and we use ADB to install Termux as we always do, and within 10 seconds, it's done. Next, let's open Termux in Chipsee Android tablet. The first time it's opened, it may need to download some packages. Then, wow, the familiar command line is back. So, is this a virtual machine? Do we still have the hardware peripherals? Do we still have our serial port devices? The answer is yes. Let's install Python and see if we can start an HTTP web server, and then let's try if we can use Android native webview to visit the web server. Let me change the background to a light theme first with Termux style. Okay, pkg install Python. We will be using Python 3 after a few minutes and it's done. But is it usable? Let's check. Python-v. Whoa, we have Python 3.11. I can't express how surprised I was when I first did this a week ago. As a guy who barely knows any Android programming, well, I did complete the greeting card example, but that doesn't really count. This Termux gives me a lot of possibilities. It means I will be able to maybe slightly nod my head when clients ask me if I can build an Android app for them, when I have a chance. So I'll then git clone and pip install a Flask web app I built for Linux. I will fast forward a little bit because this industrial quad-core Android tablet has an industrial-grade CPU. The speed is on par with a Raspberry Pi, but not as fast as our consumer PCs. One thing I want to share with Python programmers is when you install gwent, you may need to pkg install binutils so that gwent can be compiled. It took like 10 minutes compiling gwent. Let's start the Flask server with a script I wrote, bin/dev. There are a few errors I will fix later. This is the first time I run the program on this device. I haven't written the configuration file yet. Then we go back to the Android home, open a web view, and visit 127.0.0.1 on port 5000. This is a 7-inch screen. The CSS style looks a little bit weird.
Wow, this is the second time I found Termux really amazing. It just runs the Python Flask server in the background and in the same network, and my webview app can visit the server so easily. But don't forget our mission. We want to see if we can use pyserial to utilize the native RS485 serial ports of this Android tablet.
Let's run this app on two tablets. I have a 7-inch and a 10-inch industrial tablet. I connected the RS485 pins with 2-pound wires, and let's power on the devices. Then we open Termux on each device, and I'll start my Flask web server on each device. Then let's open a web browser and visit our web server. This Python Flask web app I built is open sourced on GitHub. If you are interested in the code, you can use it freely. I'm typing the IP of the web server manually. If I am to build a commercial app, I might want to compile a simple Android APK with a web view that visits this IP on startup. Then let's go to the RS485 serial port web page. Then we toggle the open close button, which will start a Python thread to let pyserial to keep listening for incoming serial messages. Now the final part. Let's send from the 10-inch device to the 7-inch device. Send a short text first. I will touch this button and it will use pyserial to send a message through RS485 to the 7-inch device. See that? I sent a short message and the 7-inch device received it.
Let's clear the screen and test if we can send from the 7-inch device to the 10-inch device. Beautiful. I can't help to press the button more times to confirm it wasn't just sent by luck. Nice, I can keep doing this on Android for a whole afternoon. But one thing Android browser has but Linux doesn't is a virtual keyboard. It saves me the effort to write a JS virtual keyboard. Let's try typing a custom message like hello Termux, and the 7-inch device received it. Really awesome. If you wonder how can I use webpage to display the changes on the screen in real time without refreshing the webpage, I will give you a hint. WebSocket. The browser is communicating with the Python Flask web server running in Termux through a WebSocket.
So that's our lab for today. I hope this video gave you some inspiration on how to use Termux and the Chipsee Android tablet in your future projects. I really appreciate all the effort Termux team and all the contributors have made. This video won't exist without them. If you wish to know more about Termux and the industrial PCs, you can subscribe to this channel. This is Gaofang. Thank you.